laser does, you can see, is that it vaporizes all the dirt, dust, debris, dead skin cells, organisms such as bacteria, fungus, parasites, above the skin. So it's almost like a vacuum cleaner. Your skin is like a surface that accumulates dirt every time, you know, you step out of the house, even inside the house. Your skin surface is just very prone to accumulating dirt. And sometimes you can't see the dirt with your eyes because the dirt is too microscopic. But just because you don't see the dirt doesn't mean the dirt is not on your skin. So the QCS laser is a very, what I call, sophisticated vacuum cleaner. It's able to vacuum clean and suck all the dirt on the surface of the skin and inside the pores. Now, inside the pores is what a lot of vacuum cleaners cannot do. A lot of facial cleansers, a lot of micro scrubbing brushes, Clarisonic brush, can only scrub the surface, but they cannot go inside the pores, because inside the pores is even tinier, and that's where you need laser to really go in and zap. Okay, so when your skin is clean, that's good. I think patients feel it after the zap, they definitely feel their skin feeling cleaner. Okay, the second thing that laser does, which that helps to reduce oil production. So all of us have oil glands in our skin, right? But some people have more active oil glands than others. So people that are going through puberty, people who sleep late under a lot of stress, or maybe have an underlying medical disorder where their oil glands are just constantly going to overdrive, these people tend to overproduce too much oil. So you see all that oil, all the oil droplets in the oil gland? When there's too much oil, the oil will spill out into the space around the hair follicle and will eventually block the pores. The problem of having too much oil is that oil attracts bacteria. That's where you get the whole infection cycle. And when the bacteria thrives, multiplies, there's inflammation, and that's how you eventually get acne. So when Quiklaser targets the oil glands in the skin, it reduces the activity of the oil glands. It doesn't stop, it reduces. That means it reduces the overall net production of oil, so that there's less oil produced, and when there's less oil, there's less blockage. When there's less blockage, there's less opportunities for the bacteria to multiply and you know, cause infection. And when you have less infection, there's less likelihood of getting inflammation. Third thing that QCS does, which is, it stimulates collagen. Okay, and collagen is found in the second layer of the skin, the dermis, not the epidermis. Laser, because of the wavelength, is able to stimulate the cells known as fibroblasts in the dermis to produce collagen. And collagen is produced by fibroblasts in the dermis. So it's produced in situ, which is what you want. Laser is able to do that. So it has a localized collagen stimulating effect in the dermis, which is why we always like to tell patients, when you do QCS regularly, you're actually increasing the thickness of your dermis. And that helps to decrease fine wrinkles in the long run. The only way is to stimulate collagen, and is to do it by using laser to stimulate the cells to produce more collagen, right? So that you lose less collagen than you would normally would with aging anyway. The fourth thing that laser does, which probably a lot of patients here are curious about, is how it lightens pigmentation. So I don't want to go too technical, but basically you can see from animation, wherever the laser shoots, it breaks down the pigment, melanin pigment in the skin, to lighten the pigment over time. Okay, obviously some pigments, there are different types of pigments. Some pigments are shallower, some pigments are deeper, some pigments are small, some pigments are patches. But so depending on the type of pigmentation, which the doctors we will diagnose from Singapore, so depending on the nature of the pigmentation, some pigmentation recurs with stress, with hormones, with sunlight. So some patients may need to do this continuously. Some patients do a few times, the pigment disappears. Okay, but the general principle is the Quiklaser is able to break down melanin on the spot. We find that Quiklaser is one of the safer ways of lightening pigmentation gradually over time. So in summary, these are the four things it does. It cleans the skin like a vacuum cleaner, what a lot of brushes, washers cannot do deep enough. It reduces the oiliness of skin, right, which is great for patients who are very prone to acne because of oily skin. It helps to stimulate collagen in the dermis, but it's very good for people, especially older women who are concerned about fine lines. They want to look younger, okay? The fourth thing is it helps to lighten pigmentation. Regardless of what type of pigmentation you have, whether it's freckles, lentigo, melasma, birthmarks, laser lightens pigmentation. So after the laser, you notice that we put the hyaluronic acid mask mm-hmm. on the patient's skin for 5 minutes. And this is a moisturizing hydrating mask. It helps to turbocharge the effects of laser, the four effects of laser, which I described earlier. So just think of it as a supplement post-treatment, okay? And that's a very quick summary of what the Quiklaser treatment does.